Stay right there.
Look at you in that cloud.
Alright, my name is Byron. I'm one of the reptile keepers here at the lair. We're going to be joined by Kay on that side of the exhibit. And it's feeding time for a Temistema. That's what these guys are. They're called Temistema or false serials. This one's a female. She's around 30 years old.
Ooh,
the male is housed on that side of the exhibit. These guys today are eating fish. These are tilapia. And that makes up a lot of their diet. They eat a lot of fish, but they eat other things.
Don't touch me, son.
Cold in the wild and here.
I'm not going to let you go. Shut up.
Kelly, mammals, birds, other reptiles, pretty much anything that hits the water and moves
around.
Let
me move your hand. Put your jacket on around your waist.
Put the gate down there for a medical worker to enter. So I'm going to tell you to get him to come a little bit back this way. And we'll start over. So Temistema are a freshwater species of crocodile that's native to Malaysia and Indonesia. There we go. They're really one of the largest species of crocodiles out there. A lot of cool attributes to them. That long, narrow snout helps them to catch fast-moving fish, and there's kind of a correlation between the snout shape of a crocodile and the amount of fish that it eats. So that in general, the more narrow-shaped snouts are animals that eat a lot more fish. And that's because they can move that snout around underwater a lot faster and a lot less
resistant.
That being said, let's get started. Let's go ahead and move our large tilapia here. If you guys look at the bottom of the pool, you might see a little teeth. Temistema and all crocodiles, they shed their teeth from time to time.
So look at the crocodile.
They're always losing them and then growing new ones back in their place. So we're doing a couple things with these guys, not just feeding them, but also training them to target these loopholes. We just have something to focus on other than us, and it's a way for us to move animals from one place to another. As she feeds, she'll take that and spin it. She'll rotate it in her mouth and swallow the head first. And they do this with all their prey. When they're swallowing fish, it helps all the spines and things fold back nice and easily. If they're swallowing a mammal or a bird, when they swallow them head first, all the limbs fold back.
It's
a lot easier to swallow prey that way. Although you feed the animals too, if they find an animal that's larger than what they can swallow, they'll tend to break them up into smaller pieces. And they'll do that by just really, like that. They'll break up the animals by slashing their head to the side really quickly and closing their jaws really hard. So their jaws end up acting like a set of shears kind of cutting the animal in half. That's what larger animals can't swallow all at one time.
Another one?
Yeah, fed them too.
Sure.
One more.
Next. No, he only got two.
Why are they making that sound?
Because it still has it in his mouth.
Why
are
they making that sound?
I'm not sure.
So crocodiles are pretty smart compared to a lot of other reptiles. They're pretty easily trained. You can see he's got a couple cues. One of them to call back over this way. Here at the zoo, these guys get a big variety of foods. That's tilapia, but they eat other kinds of fish too. They like catfish, they like trout, they like rats and rabbits, and they like quail and chicken. Pretty big variety. If it's meat and it moves around, it's food for its missing mom. Do you guys have any questions about these guys? We do have another crocodile feeding that we're going to be doing right after this, guys. If you want to see our Indian burials, they're pretty new to the zoo. They've been here a little less than a year. They're just over this way.
Get your hand.
When we're done here, we're going to move over here and we'll feed them. It's a pretty exciting feed time to watch.
Can we go watch those?
It's really interesting. Can you see? These guys are a critically endangered crocodile species. They're here as part of a long-term breeding program that a lot of U.S. zoos are working with. What they're being fed today is pieces of trout. This is just rainbow trout cut up into pieces. As they're moving around, watch their snout. You see them kind of slice through the water to get their fish. Even though the fish aren't moving, they still have that same action. Indian burials eat almost all fish, and that's why their snouts are so narrow. It helps them to catch fish. They always come up to the surface of the water to swallow their fish. These guys are young, they range in age from 6 years old to
10 years old. I found a trout tail. Huh? Look at him. It reminds me of MJ.
So they're a big species of crocodile. Like I said, they're native to India and Nepal, where they
there's
a couple of river systems where they live there, and their populations are really, really declining recently. And a big part of that is due to pollution. So because they eat fish,
pollution,
this is the best sea urchin ever. This is the first time we've ever seen them.
The predators eat those fish. Suffer a lot. And maybe that's one of the problems that these guys have. And that's if all you eat is fish and all the fish you eat are contaminated, then you have a lot of problems. So
there's another one over there.
Things change there and that can turn around and they'll eat the They share the exhibit with four turtles. There's three painted river terrapins and one slide river turtle. You might see them swimming around picking up pieces of fish or fruits and vegetables. There's one of the terrapins hanging out basking on the log right there. Have a fun night. You guys have any questions about the gharials? None were born in April. They came to the zoo here back in April. Yes, yeah. So they were hatched all at the place called the Madras Crocodile Bank. It's a breeding facility in India. And then they distributed them throughout the world to different zoos and facilities that work with crocodiles.
Turtle.
Hopefully to serve as a reservoir in case we need to do reintroduction in the future. Because it takes a lot. It takes a lot of space to house these guys, a lot of resources. So not one institution can do all of it. We all kind of have to work together for it. They're really interesting animals. They have these sensory pores.
There's still a piece of fish
skin,
right there.
Their jaws,
and
the sides of their body. And that's where they can sense their prey and sense the crocodile, right? So even if the water is completely murky and they can't see through it, if a fish swims by, they can feel that movement and react to it and strike and grab that fish right away. So really interesting animals. They're a prehistoric species, and there's fossil evidence of animals that look just like the Indian gharials living alongside the dinosaurs. So this is an animal that's been on the planet for a very long time and is seriously at risk of extinction in our lifetime. Really cool things. As you see them come up to the top and back down to the bottom, watch their eyes, you'll see them change color. That's because they have this extra membrane that it grows when they go underwater. It's kind of like putting on a set of swimming goggles when you go underwater. It helps them see better with
the eyes. Oh, yes, get it. Get it, buddy, get it.
How do you when you're underwater when you come up?
Oh, I missed it.
So for those of you just joining us, we're feeding our Indian gharials. They're eating pieces of trout.
There he is, he got it.
They get a variety of fish, but really just fish. That's what they specialize in. So trout, tilapia, catfish, freshwater. They've got a lot of teeth and they shed them from time to time. They just leave them during feeding time.
They
combat with another animal. And then another one will grow back in its place. There's no real limit to this, so they'll keep doing it all throughout their life. So over the course of a crocodile's life, they can shed thousands of teeth.
Sorry, I had that music.
The goal is to have them here definitely until they're able to breed. The reason why they're here is part of that long-term breeding program, so we can be able to reproduce them and have those hatchlings available to be populated.
Find the tail. It's right there. No.
Yeah, they're right
now. We're
so
close.
Sure, male and female. The plan is to pair them together and train during the breeding season so they can breed. But right now, it's not the right time, and if you don't pair crocodiles at the right time, we're going to
Oh. Do you got it? You got it? You find it?
Get it.
There's still fish in there, but I don't think you've missed it, because they're still eating. You'll see them fish around and grab it.
He looks like he's protecting it.
No, so do they try to eat the pearls? No, they don't. They really are fish specialists. Anything as large as pearl, they kind of eat.
Oh, there it is.
They're really interesting, though. They're a pretty rare and elusive species.
It's right in the water there.
Where they live in India, the females will build their nests on the banks of the Ganges River. And they'll deposit their eggs in this big sandy riverbank. And they can lay them at different times, but what they found is that they have the synchronous action of all the babies.
That's how MJ eats. You just give her something and then she just swallows it. Actually, I don't even think she chews it like that, though.
She chews the dry dog food.
Do
you see the
tail,
Daddy?
They're
like missing the tail.
He's the male that will protect all of the offspring. Even if they're not his own, they can be offspring from another
crocodile. Oh, look at the turtle!
So they have these pools where all the babies gather, and there's this giant 17-foot male that's there that will protect them from predators. Because when they're full grown, they really don't have much in the way of predators. But when they're young, there's a lot of animals that are going to be crocodile.
No, thank you.
Pretty interesting. That's parental care in reptiles is pretty rare.
It doesn't look like it's
called Sean. Haley, it's very rare.
Can you please get off my back?
Hi.
I know, hi. But can you get off my back, please? Thank you.
No, well, some species...
Come on, I know you smell the tail.
Alligators are the same, though. They won't protect their own young. They'll protect their own. So there's not as big of a risk of...
There is a tail.
But there isn't a lot of the other reptiles. Motor dragons are something like
They're so dumb.
Was that a rainbow trout?
Yes, it was a rainbow trout.
The crocodiles will take care of their It depends on where the sun's sitting, where the shadows are. Before we got here, they were all out of the water. During feeding time, you'll see them all in the water when they come out. So it just depends on
a bunch of teeth in there.